Alright, so now I'm going to move on to the red parts. Now, I've already pre-painted all the red parts, as you can see here. And these colors. Whoops. Using number 81 russet. Now I'm going to do a pre-shade using number 114 RML 23 red. This is a little different than the other ones. The red contrast is going to be a little tough. So see what we got here. Kind of hard to see with all the red, but the red is a little lighter. And of course, this thing doesn't want to come out all the time, so I gotta. Alright, you know what? This thing is not properly pre-thinned or not mixed. I always seem to have trouble with this. Let me think of that. Let's try some other part. This one. Okay. That looks alright. Try one last part. This one will probably be the most difficult one. Because there's a lot of sections here. Now, this is not final, of course, because once I finish applying this, I'm going to give it an overall spray, so that way it is conformed to that part. Here we go. Alright. We'll do an overall review later on. Once this dries, I'm going to repaint it again. I'm going to probably use a cloth to wipe out whatever gunks it accumulates. Because that was one thing that I noticed with airbrushing is when you spray, sometimes even if it's pre-thinned properly, a little bit of a gunk of paint ends up coming out of my nozzle. Now, it's not supposed to do that. I could probably put a little bit more thinner to thin it out, but I'm afraid that it'll come out too thin, and it'll oversaturate and wet the entire part. Yeah, like that. See, like that gunks up, and I'm gonna probably leave that alone. I'm gonna probably clean this up a bit, so. Let me work on these parts, and then we'll do a review later on. Okay, so we're now in the final stages of me painting these colors. The last color I began painting was, of course, the blue. And here is an example of one of the parts that I painted blue. If you guys want to know which blue it was the normal blue, which I can't find right now. Oh, there it is. It was this one right here, number 5. But now, I'm going to move on to the next stage, of course, is the coloring the lighter blue on it, using number 323, light blue. So I pre-thinned, and I want to make sure that this thing comes out nice and smooth, because I had a hard time dealing with this. So, this is what it looks like before the shading. Kind of difficult to do the, let's try this one. pre-shaded. But remember, this is just the base of the shading. Then I'm gonna give it the overall. Now the next part, of course, are the part of the wings in the back. This one I had a pain in the ass to paint, because the blue oversaturated and I had to sand down a lot of parts here. I may have to look into getting another airbrush, because I don't know why this thing spits out and I've already applied a lot of thinner. It comes out nice and smooth when you clock it back really fast, but when you do a small control amount. You know what? Let me put a little bit more thinner. Just give me a second here, guys. I try to do the ratio as best as I possibly can, but again, I always have that fear that I would overthin it, and it'll come out well. Let me just let it bleed out a bit more. There we go. Alright, so let's see how this works. I hate when that happens. Fortunately, these paint dries really fast. Of course, now I gotta collect all the dust off it, wipe it off, and wipe off all the fingerprints that I just applied to it right now. Okay, let's try that again. I guess applying a little bit more thinner worked. No, it didn't. God damn it. I wouldn't have had this problem, of course, if this was a metallic painted kit. Shit, I oversaturated something. Alright, well, you guys can see what I'm talking about here. Okay, so you guys get the idea. Let me continue on, and then I'm going to do an overall spray. And then we'll do a final review of all the parts. Both yellow, red, and blue.